Hi guys, welcome or welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me today. We're going to create actions in Photoshop. Just like always, if you haven't already, please do press the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. The bell icon will help you out because it gives you a notification every single time I upload a video. I upload every week and sometimes more than that if I feel like it. So yeah, like I said, basically, we're going to make some actions. Actions are amazing because basically they just help your life to be easier and more straightforward. I've got open at the moment Photoshop on a MacBook Pro. This is a 16-inch MacBook Pro. So I don't have any of my normal actions over here apart from some luminosity masks. If your Photoshop looks different to mine over here with things in different places and it doesn't look like this, don't worry, go ahead and watch the video that I'm going to link above. That will help you just basically set up your workspace so that it looks pretty much exactly the same as this. There might be some background noise in this video, and that is because there is currently a 8-week-old puppy in the background eating a Kong. So things could get rowdy. I'm gonna try and whiz through this as quickly as possible though. So basically I've just opened up an image and rotated it, done a little bit of fixing in the blank spaces there. But this picture actually was taken by Dan on his first ever solo shoot out. Okay, so the first action that we're gonna create basically switches this layer into a smart object with the camera raw filter applied on it. So it's just one of my actions that I tend to use all of the time at this stage just to get me through that little chunk of the workflow. If you're not sure about why you would be doing that, go ahead and watch the full edit video that is linked above, which does include that as a specific step. So the first thing that we need to get familiar with really is this section over here. So within the actions, I, as you guys will know, have mine set up to show as button mode. This is button mode, kind of like multicolored buttons that look like this. So to make this into a situation where we can make actions, all we need to do is go ahead into the four little lines up there, and where you're in this section and it says button mode, just click that to make it not button mode. If your actions look like this as standard, then don't worry because basically you are just in the right place. Now within the default action set, you can make a new folder if you want to. I just kind of keep mine in the same place, but you can then go ahead and click on where you want to file this new action and then click the little plus icon down at the bottom. That then brings up this window which pops up saying new action, action name. And for me, I just call this particular action camera raw filter step. I mean, like, it's just keep it simple. So you can choose the set that this is going to sit in there. You can put it on a function key and you can also give it a color. I'm just going to color these as violet for today, just because it makes it easier to see. And then we click record. Now, one thing that's really, really important at this point is don't click on layers. If you click on a layer at any point from this point onwards, it records the layer name. And then if that layer name doesn't exist, the action will not run. You'll have error messages. Things will go really, really strange. So as soon as you set up this and set it to record, you then basically need to not click on layers. Everything else needs to be done either using keyboard shortcuts or ideally the menus that you can see on the screen. So the first thing that we need to do to make a smart object layer for me in my workflow is to duplicate it. So I'm going to use the keyboard shortcuts in this case to create a duplication, which is Command and J. You'll notice that as soon as I've done that, it's recorded that step. We've done layer via copy on this particular layer over here. Then the next thing that I do is I make the uppermost layer a smart object. To do that, I'm just going to right click and then I'm going to choose convert to smart object. That will record that here as a step. So with that step successfully achieved in there, we have converted this layer to a smart object. I'm then going to go ahead and apply a camera raw filter to it. So I'm going to go filter, and then I'm going to go camera raw filter from the list here. Camera raw has then obviously opened. I don't want to make any changes to this at all, so I'm just going to click OK. And camera raw filter has been applied to this particular layer here. That's all I want to do for this action, which is super simple and straightforward. So I'm happy with that now. I'm going to press stop. With that stopped, I can then go ahead and click on layers, delete stuff, and it won't record anything in there. That's absolutely fine, because when we switch over into button mode, now magically camera raw filter step exists as an action. So with the layer that you want to make into a smart object with that camera raw filter on it selected, all you need to do then is just click on your newly created action and the action will run. So the action has ran, just like you guys can see here. So you've got basically all the things we just did, but we can go ahead, double click into camera raw filter and then continue with our edit. So in this case, my edit really is gonna probably be just to tweak some colors going on in here. So mainly the greens and the yellows. So I'm gonna tweak around with those a little bit. And then I'm gonna obviously, as normal, apply my double radials. Okay, so with those adjustments done, I'm gonna click OK. That will commit the changes down and my adjustments are now visible on the screen. So the next action that I wanna go ahead and make, remember going through the three dots and switching it back off of button mode. The next action that I want to go ahead and make is actually gonna be a basic light radial, so a movable color. If you're not sure what those are, go ahead and look at the video that will be linked above. And for that, basically all I'm going to do is set a new action again, pressing that plus. I'm going to do light radial base, and then I'm going to put that into the violet section again and click record. So with that now recording, remember we can't click on layers, so we just need to use our menu. So I'm going to go down here, I'm going to choose gradient, just like we normally do. I'm going to switch it to a radial. I'm going to make the size of it much bigger. And then I'm going to go into the colors and just tweak it to where I would usually set the colors, which is around about there for me most of the time. I'm going to click OK on that. I'm going to select the blend mode there and I'm going to set it to screen. I'm going to drop it down to around about 80%. So with those things done, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm gonna press stop and then I'm gonna delete the layer that we've just made there, switch back to button mode. I'm gonna go ahead and make a mask. If you don't know how to make masks, again, I'm gonna just, you know, link everything above. So I'm gonna put that link above now. I'm gonna go ahead and make a mask and meet you back in a sec. So with our mask created, then the next step for me is to run the action, which is to do the light radial base, which we've just created. That will pop that over the image. I then drag my mask that I've created up and adjust the opacity to suit. So in this case, I'm gonna go ahead and mask out the log as well. So let's go ahead and just do a very quick hand mask. Okay, then I'm gonna make a new action for the next step in the workflow, and that action is gonna be a vignette. So I've pressed the plus, I'm gonna do a vignette base, if I can type, and select that into the violet category, click record, and then I'm gonna go ahead and add a new solid color layer. I'm gonna drop that into black, might put it as a really dark brown actually at this stage. Click okay on that. And then basically that is it for that action. But what I will do is drop it into multiply and bring the opacity down a little bit. So with that then done, I'm gonna click stop, switch that back to button mode, delete that layer, and then run the vignette base again. Grab hold of the mask, nice big soft brush on 100% black, two on the dog, connect it with the light source, which to be fair is up at the top. Drop it to 30% opacity and break into that vignette a little bit. So we've gone from there to there with three actions and a little bit of masking. I'm not particularly happy with that on screen. I think I'll drop that into lighten blend mode and bring that down a little bit more on that light radial. I might bring it over the dog as well a little bit, just to make it a little bit more soft. Yeah, pretty good. Okay, I'll continue on with my edit. I'll meet you back in a sec. So here's where we ended up, guys. Nice and straightforward. So the main things to be aware of when you create actions are, number one, do not click on layers. Make sure that you're clicking on the right thing. Number two, do be specific in what you are selecting and what you are trying to achieve. And number three, have a plan on where you want to go. When you've done it, make sure that you go ahead and remove it and test the action, because it's really useful to do so. The main thing though, don't click on specific layers. That's kind of the biggest thing that I can suggest. You can, if you want to, go ahead and group actions and title them. So when you're going through on your, after you press record, you can then go ahead and group things, give them a name whilst you're recording, and then things can be a little bit easier to manage. But again, clicking on layers is really risky, so just be careful what you're going for. If you haven't already, please do go ahead and press the subscribe button and obviously click the bell icon. Go ahead and find us over on Instagram. That would be really, really great. And I will see you all again really, really, really soon.